Hello, everyone, and as always, welcome back to SuppTalk Radio. First off, I want to thank everybody for taking time to fill out a recent Survey Monkey. Some great advice, some great comments, and one of them I'm actually implementing today. I know we've been talking with a lot of supplement companies, but wanted to do something a little bit different. Actually talking with a very popular reviewer slash YouTuber. We've kind of built a little bit of a friendship on Instagram, and now we're actually putting a voice to the name. Anyway, folks, allow me to introduce Matt from 5-Minute Supp Reviews. Matt, welcome.
Hey, thanks. I appreciate that. And just let everybody know, I did not pay you to say popular YouTuber. I'm still new in this game, but I appreciate that compliment.
No problem. Hopefully we'll get a couple of extra followers at the end of the show here when people are listening. So Matt, we'll start off with a lot of how I always open up with people. Tell me a little bit about yourself from the supplement end. How did you fall into this crazy game?
Oh man, I mean, probably like a lot of the people that start their own company, I just love supplements. I love working out. I've played sports my whole life, so I was always into, you know, working out, taking some supplements, get better and so forth. And for a while, I was always taking something, and then I'm like, you know what, let me research this quite a bit, and I want to create my own pre-workout. I love pre-workouts. If you watch my channel, that's my favorite thing. I usually do about 90% pre-workouts.
Yep.
And so for a while, I was creating my own, and I loved it. And as people know, the toughest thing to do is flavor, man. Those stems are tough to mask, but hey, I mean, you know, quick gulp, done, and you're on your way. But I've just been taking supplements for a long time, and I was just like, you know what? Let me just start reviewing these. I have plenty here, and let me go and see how it goes. I'll give it a year. If it, you know, works, I'll continue it. But hey, so far so good.
So you just decided to just kind of just jump into the pool and I mean, just decided to open up a chat.
Pretty much. I mean, I debated for it for quite a while. I'm just like, do I want to do it? You know, I have a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old, so I was just like, well, at the time, you know, I had one kid at the time, and just like, well, let me see, you know. So I didn't want to take away from family time. That was my thing. And one of the big things was is a lot of these reviewer channels, which, you know, I'm friends with a lot of them and so forth, but, you know, sometimes they take a while. And I know with me, with one kid and one on the way, I was like, I don't have this much time. I just want to know what the review is and so forth, straight to the point. So I'm like, hold on, 5-minute sub reviews. There you go, right there. I'll do a, you know, quick on, or quote unquote, try to be funny intro, go through the supplement facts, you know, taste tests, which, you know, on pre-workouts is a bonus if it tastes great. And then give everybody my honest performance rating, and then that's it. You know, you're in and out within 5 minutes because a lot of people are pretty busy right now.
So do you actually have a clock all, like, off to the corner when you're taping with a countdown?
Nope.
So you know? You're just doing it all by memory or just hoping it's within 5 minutes?
I cross my heart. I just say a little prayer, like, Lord, let this be in 5 minutes. And a few of the reviews, you know, went over. I'm like, oh, crap. So I had to, like, cut out some stuff, you know. And the funny thing is I did a collab with TJ from Fitness Deal News once, and it was over 13 minutes, and that was my only review so far that's been over 5 minutes. And you know, I'll make exceptions for, you know, cases like that.
Was there somebody that you followed pretty intently from a reviewer standpoint that said, you know, hey, I like him or I want to follow him, or somebody that actually, you know, kind of led you down the game?
Honestly, no, because I like I said, I've been doing this for a while, taking supplements and watching just random people. And if anything, I would say, you know, I'll take something from that person, but I want to add my own flair, my own thing. And that's why if you ever watch my videos, I know you have, I have the green screen, which everything I've researched on my own, the lighting, the green screen, the editing I learned on my own. And I just want to do that and the scooper rating, just something a little different, you know, in the 5 minutes, just keep it straight and to the point.
So now what was I've gone through a lot of your videos. I'm trying to go all the way back. What was your very first review you ever did?
Oh man, don't look at it because, you know, first review is pretty brutal. I think it was Erez White, to be honest with you, and it was Christmas of 2017 is when I was like, you know what, I'm doing this. Let's just just take this one shot and do it.
Yep.
So I had a couple reviews lined up, and I go back sometimes to watch it, and I just cringe. You know, I'm like, oh boy. So you know, you learn, you adapt, you grow. If you don't fail, you're not going to get better. So I can tell I learned a lot from, you know, Christmas of 2017.
Do you do a couple of off-air takes? Do you do it like a couple of dry runs in your head? Or do you just record and just kind of let it fly?
Oh, man. I try to think of something, you know, related to the supplement I'm reviewing. You know, like I said, I try to do a quote-unquote funny little skit or a couple of funny lines in there just to make it interesting, because supplements is a pretty boring subject, especially trying to pronounce some of the supplements. Man, I butchered them in the past. I still do. And it, you know, it's not something simple, but most of the time I'll go on the fly and just go with it, because I want to be real and honest and get that, especially with the flavor rating. I'm like, oh, okay, this is pretty good. Oh, God, this sucks. But, hey, you know how the saying goes, if a supplement sucks taste-wise, it's probably going to work performance, which is usually the case. So, but I have had a handful of outtake videos, and my favorite word is fudge, because I don't swear. And, you know, sometimes I'll say fudge about 10 times, you know, during these videos.
I actually, before we connected here a minute ago, I was actually came across one of your, I call it a blooper reel. I don't know if you called it a blooper reel.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was quite funny, because one of your lines was, oh, this is really, I think you said large or long, and you said, oh, can I say that in front of mom or something?
Yeah.
And then you're like, thank you for watching, and you're like, wait a minute, this is 10 seconds in, they haven't even watched it yet.
I know, it's like my mind goes, you know, it's like 10 seconds in advance of my mouth sometimes, which can get me in some trouble, but that's why I just like, you know what, I have so many of these bloopers, you know, let me just put it on YouTube and stuff, you know, just say, hey, this really happens behind the scenes. It's not always perfect as it goes and so forth, you know, because people see edits and, you know, stops. Wait, why is he different position here or there? So it's just, it is what it is. You know, I mean, I'm not perfect. I don't, you know, expect to be perfect. So I think it's, you know, making fun of myself, but in a fun way with everybody.
You know, and I respect you for it, because it's always that fine line of, do people want perfection, okay, or do people like raw and honest? Like when I do the shows, mm-hmm. I do very little edits to my shows, very little.
Yeah.
And the same thing with my YouTube videos. I might take one or two takes, but I'll also go ahead and edit just a little bit. But I'm like, if people looking at it, you know, respecting both of us because they see either the nerves, the jitters, the realness, or people like, this guy's a goofball because he's not polished and professional. Not you, but I'm just saying in general.
Yeah. No, I didn't take that personal. But and I understand, for me, you know, I've had a discussion with a couple of friends of mine and so forth, is you want to be professional way you want to present yourself. And what I think what I'm doing is, these companies send me products, I'm thankful for that, so I want to do it as a, you know, quote-unquote info commercial for them selling the products. Because going in, the only thing I can look at is the supplement panel, you know, okay, or supplement facts, this has this and this in there, okay, you know, I think it should work or it might not, or oh wow, that really did work, so I'm surprised. And I want to, you know, so they can show it to their customers, like, hey, Matt thought this was awesome. I'm not saying, you know, you should buy it because of my opinion, but I try to respect the companies that, you know, I do work with.
Matt, do you actually have a criteria, or do you just basically give everybody a chance? If anybody sends you a product, or do you have a criteria that I won't try this product based on X, Y, and Z, or?
That's a good question. Put it this way, is I'm a stim junkie. I love my stims, you know. My sweet spot's around 450, 500 milligrams of caffeine, plus the other, you know, yeah, I love it, you know, but I have reviewed recently one that had, I think, 150 milligrams of caffeine, but it was a little bit more pump ingredients, and I have one I'm reviewing now, it has 200, so I get a little bit of energy from it. But I also have, you know, a friend from the gym or two friends from the gym tested that don't take pre-workouts that often, see how they react, and I mentioned that in my review, saying, oh, hey, George from across the street, he's tried it and he didn't get any energy, and it's, you know, 250 or 300, and he really is like pre-workout. So I try to be honest, trying to be like, oh hey, look at the profile, this is not bad, but this is a beginner workout, you're gonna get a little boost of energy, some pumps, you know, maybe a little endurance from a half a clinical dose of beta-alanine or something along those lines. But yeah, I review anybody and give a fair honest. Sometimes I don't take stims for a couple of days, which is pretty tough for me,
yep,
especially in my field. But I try to do that when I'm going to review a smaller caffeine-based pre-workout.
Matt, are you open to both prop and full disclosure? Do you care what it is?
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing. And I've said this to people in the past, is with prop blends, if, you know, in a pre-workout, if it works, I don't complain or care as much. So if I take the next one that maybe got a little bit reformulated and it doesn't work, okay, I won't take it again. But you know, sometimes it's nice to see what ingredients are in there and how much. To me, it's not the end of the world, because with pre-workouts, there's so many out there. Hey, if you know, this one works and it's prop blend, sweet, I'll keep using it. if this one's full disclosure and it doesn't work, I'll go to another one. It's a toss-up. I know some people like it, some people don't, but I mean, more in a, we'll say an intro workout or protein, I want to know full disclosure, but pre-workouts, some people will hate it, some people will like it.
Have you tried Hooligan by Apollon or Apollon?
Apollon Nutrition, yeah, I reviewed that, man. That 600 milligrams of caffeine in there, that energy, it's not like you break through a wall. It's like 6-7 hours of energy, and I reviewed their I'm going to say sister company, Anarchy Labs Assassin. Holy cow, that, if you ever look at my review for that, that is one of the craziest pre-workout labels I've ever seen in my life.
But is it more stims than the Hooligan?
Yes, it
oh my God.
It blows Hooligan away, yeah. I mean, it has, I think, 300 milligrams of radiogenesis, DMHA, I think alpha yodin in it. I reviewed it a couple months ago, but man, that was an insane label.
And that's what scares me, though. And again, I'm the opposite. I keep myself stim sensitive. I'm not, I drink a cup of coffee a day. I might have a pre-workout, but I keep myself the opposite so I don't burn myself out and I'm not okay. But God, I give you credit. And anybody that's doing, multiple Red Bulls or Hooligan, I give you a lot of credit, man.
Yeah, and here's the thing, too, is a lot of the people out there are drinking, at least a Red Bull or a Bang, which is Bang 300 milligrams of caffeine plus a pre-workout. So you're looking at 600 milligrams of caffeine, not probably back-to-back, but, throughout the day, if not more. If people have a couple cups of coffee, that's, like 85 milligrams a cup. So, I mean, you can be caffeine sensitive and so forth, but you just got to be careful that you don't want a two-scoop Hooligan with 600 milligrams of caffeine just to fill it.
Matt, when you do your reviews, how much does the flavor count? I guess I want to say this properly here. When you do reviews, how impactful is the flavor versus the actual efficacy of how you feel of the dosage?
Yeah. Now for pre-workouts, I could care less about the flavor, to be flat honest with you. I said that countless times in my videos, but I still give a rating of 1 to 5 scoopers, 1 being the worst, 5 being the best. I've never had a 5-scooper rating on anything, flavor or performance, but, pretty close to some. So pre-workouts, if they taste good, which is 2019, you would think, it could be tasting good, but I understand some of these stims are so tough to cover up. But pre-workouts, it's all right, but like an intra-workout, like a BCA or EAs that I'm drinking throughout my workout, I want that to taste good because I'm drinking that the most and I'm sipping on it. So protein and EAA/BAs, I want to taste the matter the most.
No, and I can get that. So over the reviews you've done over the years, what do you think your, based on your personal preference, and again, folks, this is based on Matt, what have been your maybe 3 to 5 top pre-workouts, just in general, that you've enjoyed most?
I did quite a bit of top 5 or 10 pre-workouts, BCAs, energy drinks of 2018. And my number one for the big companies, because if you know me, I love reviewing small companies. That's what I deal with a lot. I just love what they bring to the table. I love dealing with small companies, maybe because I'm a small guy, just working my way up. And, I want to give them the fair shot and hey, you might find that diamond in the rough, which I think I did a few times. But one of the bigger companies I reviewed was Rage Nutrition, and it was at the time Formula X, but now it's Immortal. And man, that one just hit hard, and that's one I collab with TJ on it, and we both agree on it. It hit hard, and we'll be reviewing his version 2 coming up soon. But I had that as my number one of 2018, and then Anarchy Labs Assassin was number 2. That one just lasted, like I said, about 6-7 hours of just constant energy. And then a new company, I think you had them on here, was Wrecked from Seaside Sports.
Yes. Good guys.
Oh, man, I enjoyed that podcast. But, man, that pre-workout, it's solid. Pumps, stims, I mean, no matter what, if you want your pumps or stims, it was all around awesome. I really enjoyed that. That hit pretty good, too. So I'd say those are probably the 3 up there. And then the small company was Fueled Supplements. Oh, boy, I'm having a brain fart. Blood Rounds was my number one for a small company, and I think they're just going to be making waves in 2019, which they already are. They're signing a lot of MMA and so forth fighters, so check them out if you can.
Matt, I hear obviously a lot of stims, but do you gravitate for a secondary? Are you more of a pump guy, more of a focus, or do you even care for the secondary? Because it sounds like everything is stim to you.
Yeah, pretty much. And here's the thing too, is that's what a lot of my viewers like, is that there's stims out there. If you look, stim junkie workouts or high stims or strongest, you know, pre-workout, that's what a lot of people want. And I consider myself one of them as well, but I love nupits and pre-workouts, and which I've been saying in my recent videos is I've been reviewing some that have a stim profile but nupits in there and so forth. I love just the focus agents, and then pumps to the last, just because of if you take so many stims and caffeine, you know, it's opposite of a pump. You need to open it, and the caffeine closes it, so you can't get 400, 500 milligrams of caffeine and expect huge pumps.
And I think people don't understand that, and it's good that you bring that up, because I don't think people understand the vasoconstriction and the vasodilation. Like you said, they counteract each other when you have a lot of caffeine and then with the citrulline or the agmatine and everything else.
Agreed, yeah, and I don't think, you know, a lot of people are informed on that, but it's tough because you want the best of both worlds, but, you know, where do you sacrifice? And so there got to be a line somewhere, and hopefully, you know, we can find a way of getting our stims plus our pumps like solid both, you know, each time.
Now, Matt, I know you and I were talking the other day offline, and are there any companies that when you started this that you were like really blown away saying this is going to be, you know, a great company, and they wound up closing shop on you? Not on you, but just in general. I know we kind of talked about that offline.
Yeah, and that's, I talked to another CEO about that. You know, he's a bigger company. And, you know, like I mentioned, I deal a lot with small companies, and I go back and like, oh, yeah, I remember that video. Let me watch that again. And I'm like, let me see what they're doing. I haven't seen them post on Instagram, which I reach out to a lot of companies on Instagram. And your user cannot be found. I'm like, oh, okay. Or, hey, they haven't posted in 6 or 7 months. I'm like, oh, boy. I mean, I kind of saw that coming, you know, because it was a very underdosed pre-workout, because you could just tell and, you knew, like, oh, you kind of hope for the best, but kind of knew it was going to happen sooner or later. And I'm like, wow. But hey, this is an oversaturated market. It's tough. And, you know, some of these small companies, if you can't market, you know, that's the way to get out there. You just flood the market and hope for the best.
Exactly, exactly. So I know, too, we talked the other day, and I don't know if I want to go down too much of a negative path, but are you in the same agreement as I am that, again, a lot of great pre-workouts out there, but there seems to be a lot of redundancies that everybody's using, you know, again, great ingredients as citrullines and agmatines and the alpha GBC, but do you think it's time for somebody to come out with something more game-changing?
Yes, I've been waiting for a while, and I talked to my one buddy. You know, 2018 was somewhat of a disappointment just because there wasn't much new ingredient-wise. And, you know, for me, and any YouTuber supplement YouTuber is, you know, oh, hey, this one has 300 milligrams of caffeine. Oh, this has 6 grams of L-citrulline. Oh, beta-alanine 3.2 grams, this and that. It's pretty much the same thing. The only thing might be different is the flavor. Or, hey, this is really good flavor. How can that be a good flavor and this one sucks or whatever, but it's all about the performance. And I mean, I see pretty much a similar profile throughout the pre-workouts I've been reviewing. So yeah, I agree. I wish there was a new stim or a new pump ingredient, which there, you know, are coming out, like Vaso 6, another pump ingredient. And, you know, so I just wish there was something new to the game, but I don't know how expensive that can be.
Well, that's it, because I guess I look at it this way, is if I'm a consumer, and again, I'm not knocking any of my former guests. They all have great products, great flavors, and again, everybody's using nowadays efficacious dosages, so I'm not knocking that. But if I'm a consumer and walk into a store or look online, and I've got three products in my hands, and the ingredients are all the same, and flavor is kind of secondary to me, what's going to make me buy it? It's going to be a price point, because there's no brand loyalty anymore.
Yeah, and I agree, and that's the thing, too, is if you have three in front of you and one's, you know, and the other thing, too, is I noticed, you know, the standard used to be 30 servings, and I call this out a lot in my videos. I've been seeing a lot of 25s. I've been seeing, you know, a handful of 20 servings now, and I'm like, well, if the price point, if, you know, associates it accordingly, I'm not as mad, but if it's, you know, $40 or 20 servings compared to another one, I can get $40 or 30 servings, well, of course I'm going to do the 30 if they're close. And supplement panel wise, why wouldn't I? I'm a, you know, if I'm buying these, I got to make sense, you know, for my money to go to the right place.
And it's also the opposite, too, where people are doing the 20 and 40, where 40, yes, you get half the dosage,
yeah,
but then you get 20 for the full. So it's like, well, which really is the right way to go?
Yeah, and that's the thing, too, is majority of us that, you know, like our pre-workouts and take them, we're going to use that 20 servings. And when it, you see 40, that's why when I see 40 or even 50, I'm like, yeah, cut that in half. And what also I'll try and do, too, is if I can take two scoops the one time, if I'm going to go do a cardio or something along those days, or, hey, I need a pick-me-up, that one scoop usually, you know, hits the spot where I can get my little boost of energy, a little bit of focus and so forth, and I'm not wasting a whole pre-workout serving.
So, Matt, do you take pre-workouts daily even if you're not working out? Or are those the days that you kind of decompress yourself?
Yeah, pretty much, but I do have to take breaks, and that's when I'll review other types of supplements, like a protein powder or BCAs or something. But yeah, if I don't take a break for a couple of days, maybe a week tops, I have to double, triple scoop some pre-workouts, and I don't want to do that. I want to give all my reviews honest review.
So when you're, and I'm gonna switch gears here again. So when you're getting ready to use a pre-workout, do you jump in front of the screen, take it, and then run to the gym, do your workout, and then come back and finish up the rest of the video?
It's tough, and I don't know if we talked about this earlier in our video. And the big thing is as you know, my YouTube videos are 5 minutes or less, and we've been talking about 20 some minutes. So this might be a record. I don't know if people are you know, sleeping or still entertained, but I have two kids. I have a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old, so I got to work around this, around family life. I told, you know, the wife, aka the boss, that I wouldn't let this interfere with family life. It does, let me know, because that's more important than anything to me. But the funny thing is I'll take the pre-workouts usually before I go to the gym, and then I'll do the review part. Probably when the kids are in bed, the wife's in bed, about 10:30, 11 at night, I'll be reviewing. Sometimes it takes me a couple edits. Next thing you know, it's midnight. I'm like, oh, man, I've got to edit this video, do this, get the thumbnail ready. So, yeah, it can be – it varies, put it this way.
So for I want to peek behind the curtain here. So when you do your green screen, do you actually have – is it a green sheet, or is it actually like a true like screen?
It's a thick green fabric I bought. You know, I did research, like I mentioned earlier, online, and I got – bunch of lighting, because lighting's key in this, and just edit, you know, trial and error, and just make sure I got it. And finally, you know, I watched YouTube videos how to set this up, edit this, do that, and hey man, I've been doing it for I want to say about 7-8 months, but probably even longer, to be honest with you.
So do you actually have an they're not the right proper term, but do you have those umbrella type lights? It looks like an umbrella around the light.
Yeah. I have four of them lined up in a, I guess, semicircle, and then in my basement, it's my little office down there where I have this all set up.
I was going to ask you, so you know, your wife doesn't make you take it down, that's your area, you can leave it as it is.
Yep, that's my AKA man cave.
And do you use your phone, or do you have a professional video recorder?
No, I've been using my iPhone. I started out with, I think, iPhone 6S Plus, now I'm on a 7, and I've been using that since, so, you know, works fine. I don't make money on this. Anything I get is, you know, free supplements. So, you know, I'm still, I think I'm almost at 400 subscribers, and I've been doing this for just a little bit over a year. So I don't think it's too bad. This is a niche market. It's tough, you know, especially being under 5 minutes. You know, YouTube wants you to have longer videos, but hey, I have that market. I want to hit that 5 minutes with.
You know what though, but research that I do says that it, and I guess it's very debatable. I've read things that say to do a review or get your point across in 90 to 120 seconds. I think for a product review, that's a little light. But I'm not just stroking your ego or anything, but I think 4 to 5 minutes is good. I think sometimes when you start going into 9, 10, 15 minutes, I think that's when you truly lose people.
And I agree, and that's part of the reason why I started this company, this channel.
You're a brand, man. You're a brand.
Yeah, my brand. Just because of that, you know, I'm busy. You have a lot of people are busy. You want to get this, you want to get in and out, get the information you want. And like we talked about earlier, is a lot of the pre-workouts are pretty much, you know, the same supplements minus a few here and there. So yeah, I can, you know, I don't want to say I consider myself like a musician singing the same songs going from city to city, it just gets boring. You're like, oh my gosh, I got to do this song again, even though the fans might like it.
Yep.
But, you know, so instead of going through every supplement, you know, or every ingredient, I try just to handpick a few, and then we'll say this company has this different one, like lion's mane extract for nootropics in it. I'll talk about that for, you know, maybe 20, 30 seconds, you know, to get the benefits of it. And like, hey, this, you know, you might be seeing this more in this upcoming companies and so forth, blah, blah, blah. But everybody knows what caffeine does. Everybody knows what L-citrulline does. Everybody knows what beta-alanine does. But, you know, so it's just like, I don't want to do that, you know. So I try to make it interesting because, you know, I want to keep people, you know, involved in the video.
It, you know, it's true though, because you don't want to be redundant for the people that follow you intently, but in the same boat, the one time you don't explain what citrulline is or agmatine, it's going to be that brand new subscriber that really doesn't know what it is.
Yeah, and I agree too, and I try to pinpoint, you know, some of the key ones when I can, and I do mix it up, you know, a couple, I would just do a few ingredients, and then maybe a couple weeks later, I'll do the full panel, you know, depending on how large the panel is. Some, a couple of these I'm doing only have like five or six ingredients. So, yeah, I have enough time. I can go through all of them.
Matt, fast forward now. You've got a year under your belt. How many takes do you really do per video where you get it down?
And we're being recorded. And I'm under oath. Oh, man. The funny thing is sometimes I tell you it's just the stupidest things that just mess me up. And if you look at my camera roll, for a five-minute video, sometimes I have like 20-some takes. I'm like, what the crap's going on here, you know? I mess up on one stupid thing and just each time. But sometimes I can get away with like two or three takes and I'm good, which I'm like, yes, thank you. And there's sometimes I'm just like, what's going on, you know? It just adds up and up. It's just, I just laugh at myself.
Do you have a goal on how many you want to do a week, a personal goal?
I do two to three, and I pretty much stick with that since my get-go. Like I said, I'm not, you know, being paid or sponsored enough, big enough that I have tons of people sending me stuff, but I have a lot of pre-workouts and protein powders and, you know, BCAAs that I've been sent, so I'm very thankful and always will be thankful for that. So I can't do one every single day. Even though it's 5 minutes, it takes a good bit to do that and then edit it, you know, and so forth. So,
Matt, one of my last questions here, because I know you've got to be somewhere soon. What is your honest opinion for people that come up with these crazy or inventive flavors? And I mean, not like a typical fruit punch. There was one you did the other day, and I forget who it is now, that was something weird, and you kept saying, I wonder if this is going to taste like fruit punch. Nah, it can't be fruit punch. But if it's that, those weird kind of flavors, well, you know it's fruit punch, but it's, you know, sucker punch or something.
Yeah, it was punch and punch, and I knew going in it was gonna be you know, fruit punch just by the name. And like I said, I try to say a couple quote unquote wannabe funny lines, whatever, just to break it up, you know, because supplements are dull and so forth. But you know, I can't tell you how many fruit punch or renditions of fruit punch I've tried, or blue raz. I you know, does it make sense? Or are they cheap to flavor that way, or do they mask the majority of the stems? I don't know. That's one thing maybe you can ask a future company, if they have fruit punch or blue raz. Hey, why do you do fruit punch? Is it cheap? Does it mask the stems? But I enjoy those companies, especially the small ones that, you know, come out swinging with, you know, a loaded pre-workout or something along those lines, some awesome different flavor. Hey, if you don't try, you never know. And, you know, so I kind of like those different types of pre-workout flavors.
I can answer that question quickly, because I do ask some of my guests that, and they're torn, because they're torn because some of them want to be safe for a fruit punch or blue raz, and some of them just don't give a darn, and they go ahead and throw caution to the wind. The peach mangoes and the cherry lemonades and stuff, and it's that fine line of, do I be safe or do I risk it and go with something exotic and possibly turn people off? And I know that's the biggest dilemma that these people have.
Yeah, and actually I do remember you talking to, I think, Adam Flesner from
Get Strong.
Yeah, and he went the El Natural route, which, you know, it could be a bold choice just because of, you know, the flavoring and so forth. But and I understand. But
I'm an exotic guy myself. I'm an exotic guy. I get excited when I see something new and exciting.
Exactly, too. I'm like, oh, give me that one. And right now my go-to flavor is blueberry lemonade, and the Chaos Crew, man, they killed that flavor the other day with Bring the Chaos pre-workout. They're from Europe, and, oh, man, that's one of my favorite ones in 2019 so far.
I'll have to look that up. Matt, as we wind down here, is there anything else that you want to tell the listeners or anything else maybe we haven't discussed in this conversation?
I think we covered a lot. This is about six times my video length, so I think we're good. I appreciate this. It was fun. I'm glad I don't have to edit anything. You know, I can hang up the phone and go along with my life. But, you know, if everybody just wants to, I don't know if I could do a quick plug.
Oh, no, go for it. All yours. All yours, man.
Thanks. I appreciate that. Free of charge. You know, just look me up on YouTube. I'm 5 Minute Supp Reviews. Same thing on Instagram. If you want to give me a follow, I appreciate that. And, you know, if you want something reviewed, just leave me a comment. I'll be more than glad to reach out to that company.
And, folks, let me just verify a little bit, Matt. It's the number 5. It's not the word 5.
Correct. Yes, the number 5. Thanks for pointing that out.
Oh, no worries. Well, folks, as always, I appreciate you folks, you know, downloading us, giving Matt here and myself a platform to chat. Let us know what you think. If you like what you hear between Matt and I, let us know. I'd love to have Matt back. And if you guys don't, then, oh, well, we just move on and keep friends. But, Matt, as always, I appreciate your time and have a great weekend.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And everybody have a good weekend, whenever you listen to this, weekend or weekday. So thanks again.
Perfect. Thanks, Matt. Take care of yourself. Today.